Idleman Unplugged is part of the Edify podcast network.
I want to see your face pass me by the crowds of people, the priest who sing your praise.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Idleman Unplugged. I am your host, Luke Duncan. As Westside Christian Fellowship prepares for a season of fasting and prayer, Pastor Shane reads you the seventh chapter of his new book, 40 Days to Reset Your Life, Applying God's Wisdom for Physical and Spiritual Renewal. 40 Days to Reset Your Life is available in audio form on Audible, as well as Amazon Kindle, and free electronic or PDF formats at wcfav.org. We hope that you enjoy this segment of Idleman Unplugged.
A hunger and thirst for your righteousness, and it's only found one grace.
Chapter 7, if you fail, fall forward. This is one of my most favorite chapters because it encourages people to get back up and keep fighting. That's really how you succeed at anything in life, including a 40-day reset, including a weight loss program or a healthy lifestyle change, is you get back and you keep moving forward. So let's talk about this for a minute. Although I do believe that the best type of fast is to drink clean, pure water, there are other things that you can do, such as drinking juice, eating healthy, cutting out sugar. You can fast intermittently, more on that later, and so on. But it's also great to take a break from the negative news and unproductive entertainment during this time as well. So it's not only a fast for your body from food, it's also a mental and spiritual time of fasting from negative news, but also inputting good things, inputting the word of God. So as you're removing bad things, you have to be putting in good things. You have to replace that with something. For example, they say if you take out the sugar and the bad food, make sure you're putting some good food in because it has to offset that. So fasting, though, in the truest sense of the word, is refraining from eating or drinking anything that delivers nutrients to your body. So biblically speaking, fasting clinics, it's just water, very clean water. That's it. Well, what about lemon juice? Well, I mean, you can put some lemon juice in your water, but you know, some experts argue that the minimal amount of nutrients still somewhat affects the body. I don't really get that hardcore about it. If I happen to put a little lemon in there or some frozen strawberries, as long as I don't eat them, I'm going to benefit a little bit from the nutrients there. But fasting in its purest sense is just clean water, not broth, not soup, not juice, not even coffee. Some people recommend coffee, but I don't. If you're trying to fast, what is the point of putting in a stimulant? So anyway, once you take a break from the negative news and start to get in God's word and start to fast, you'll begin to see how beneficial this actually is. However, if a person can't fast or fast perfectly, isn't it better for them to end up the 40-day challenge 20 pounds lighter and feeling great, even though they didn't fast or eat perfectly? So again, it's not about perfection. It's about direction. And when you fail, when you fall forward. Isn't it better for a person to eat a handful of nuts during a fast if they feel terrible, but they need to coach their kid's sports team? Isn't it better for a person to overcome alcohol, nicotine, or pain meds, even though they didn't do things perfectly during their fast? Well, let me answer that for you. Absolutely. When life throws you a curveball, get back up to the plate and swing again. Now, I'm not advocating caving in. I'm not saying, well, just, you know, blow it here and there. That's okay. I'm offering hope for the discouraged. I'm offering encouragement for those who have no encouragement and are very discouraged. Caving in doesn't necessarily mean that you go all the way back to home plate or back to the starting line, and eating a bad meal doesn't reverse all of your hard work. Yes, again, it's best to fight through the detox process and experience the full benefits of fasting and clean eating. But we also need encouragement for the journey. We need to continue moving forward despite setbacks. Viewing detox symptoms as healthy pains will help you push through. I hope you caught that because that's important. If you view or look at your detox symptoms, headache, groggy, flu-like, you know, as long as it's not bad, it's just normal detox symptoms. If you look at those as healing pains, and I guess you could say healthy pains, then it will help you push through. Don't listen to armchair quarterbacks. As I follow fasting forums on social media, I'm amazed at how many arrogant armchair quarterbacks stand on the sidelines critiquing those who don't follow their exact protocol. Instead of encouraging people, they say things like, if you put lemon juice in your water, or if you drink herbal tea, which actually has no calories, and you chew gum with xylitol, real, almost calorie-free, you're not really fasting. You blew it. Start over. What's wrong with you? You need to do this perfectly. Well, give me a break. Granted, consuming minimal amounts of nutrients can temporarily disengage cleansing, but nitpicking and critiquing others is not helpful. For example, if I have a piece of xylitol gum with 5 calories, it might knock you out of autophagy for 8.2 seconds. It's so minimal. Again, I understand what they're saying, but we have to also give people grace and some flexibility. So don't let the negative Nellies, the judgmental Jerrys, or the critical Kathys sidetrack you. Most of them don't fast perfectly themselves. Don't quit if you slip and lose your footing. Get back up and keep running the race. Again, hardcore fasting advocates may not agree. But that's okay. They aren't in your shoes and they're not in my shoes. Your 40-day reset should be practical as well as powerful. Recall what I said earlier. We need encouragement and grace to push through. That's the point of this chapter. You might need to listen to this chapter on an ongoing basis. Humility through failure. As a perfectionist, or at least I try to be, from reading this manuscript over 20 times looking for the perfect word, or whether it's having my desk spotless and clean, God has taught me a great deal through failure in key areas of my life. And one such area is fasting. When I do things in my own strength and try to be perfect, I fall flat on my face. It's clear that I need His grace and His mercy on a daily basis. God often uses failure to keep us humble. Even with my fasting experience mentioned later on, I didn't do things perfectly. I went days with just water, but then I would eat a little bit if I had to do a big project, take a trip, or handle an important issue. Instead of beating myself up because I missed perfection or what I perceived as perfection, God looked at my heart. He saw my heart. I failed forward and kept going, and so should you. As a famous poem declares, for all of life is like a race with ups and downs, and all you'd have to do to win is rise each time you fall. Regardless of whether you're on your 100th diet attempt or can't seem to make health a lifestyle, get back up and fight again. Success is not final, failure is not fatal, and it's with courage you have to continue. That's what counts, Winston Churchill. And Henry Ford, obviously the founder of Ford, reminds us, when everything seems to be going against you, remember that an airplane takes off against the wind, not with it. And you need to fail forward. And man, if I can fast perfectly, I'm all for that. And I know people who have got on a juice fast and they fasted perfectly because they just had juice. I would say there's a lot more gray area in that type of fast because, you know, you can... You have a little juice, have some nutrients, have some watermelon juice and strawberry juice, and that's a lot of sugar, a lot of nutrients, and it is much easier to fast, I will tell you that, from juicing. But also with fasting, it's the heart. So if you're striving for perfection, you're letting people know, I've already went 5 days, I've went 7 days, I went 10 days. I remember I did a 9-day fast, I believe it was, in August a couple years ago, and I could tell, you know, it was pride was welling up a little bit, and boy, this is the longest I've ever been. And then heading home from church, God just released me, said, time to eat. And I'm like, oh, wow, I think it could have went longer, but okay, I'll stop the fast. And so my concern with fasting is we look at it like earning bonus points with God, or God's going to do even greater things in our life because, look, I'm fasting. Aren't I spiritual? But on the flip side, I believe God can do more in a person whose life is a lifestyle of discipline, the fasted lifestyle, saying no to the flesh to be filled with the Spirit. And during that journey, there are failures. There are times when we fall. And I love that scripture. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And even though he may fall, the Lord upholds him with his right hand. Thank God for that, because it's God who pulls us back up. You need to know, I don't know who's listening right now. You could be 100 pounds overweight, 200 pounds overweight. You could be addicted to chocolate, sugar, alcohol. You could be addicted to opiates or tons of caffeine, and you just have to have your bottle of wine every night. I want to tell you there is hope, but it is a struggle. And many times when it gets difficult, that's when we give up. But this fasted lifestyle is a lifestyle of saying no to things that pull us away from God. And I love the pain of discipline over the pain of regret. And as you discipline your body, what happens is the fruit comes later, even though it feels challenging, it feels difficult, the fruit of discipline comes later. And that's why many people don't do things. I just don't feel like it. That's why many people don't go to the gym. That's why many people don't work out. That's why many people don't fast. That's why many people don't change their lifestyle. That's why many people don't read the Word of God or come to prayer meetings or go to church more often than not. I just don't feel like it. So you need to crucify King's stomach. You need to fire your defense attorney who is filled with excuses within, and you need to commit everything to God. Say, Lord, I need your help. I need to fall forward. I don't care if you're on your 20th attempt. You need to give it to God and say, Lord, I need you to help get me through this. I'm going to fall forward. I'm going to fail forward. I'm going to accomplish this by grace and mercy. And Lord, I need you to just help me through this. And that will be a prayer that God will answer, because now you're going into it with the spirit of humility and gentleness and meekness. So just be encouraged. I have not fasted perfectly. I have not eaten perfectly. It is a lifestyle of moving in the right direction. And again, not giving permission, definitely not giving permission to sin, but I am allowing some boundaries and some freedoms in there for those who are trying to change their lifestyle. And you have to remember, that's the key. It's not a 40-day diet or a 40-day fix, or just take this pill, or I'm going to try. And people, I've seen, talked to a lot of people, all right, I'm going to fast even for a week, 7 days water only, or 12 days water only, or 21 days water only. And tremendous results, but then they just go right back to their old lifestyle. They gain the weight back. Success has to be maintained, I guess is what I'm trying to say. You can post that, you can tweet that. That is a biblical truth. Success has to be maintained. That's why the scriptures say, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Not work for it, work it out until the day we are buried and we breathe our last breath. Life here is a battle. Life is a battleground, not a playground. And success comes by those who continually get back up and keep fighting. And I hope that helps. And I hope you listen to this chapter again. And I hope you are encouraged.
If you've enjoyed this episode of Idleman Unplugged, be sure to check out the links in the description to get your copy of 40 Days to Reset Your Life, Applying God's Wisdom for Physical and Spiritual Renewal. You can download the book for Kindle on Amazon or for free in PDF or electronic format at wcfav.org. Again, my name is Luke Duncan, and I am your host of Idleman Unplugged. Thank you for listening to us today, and join us again on the next episode.
Thank you for listening to Idleman Unplugged. For more information, visit us at ShaneIdleman.com. Again, that's ShaneIdleman.com.
This podcast is part of the Edify Podcast Network. Edify is a faith-inspiring app that brings together thousands of the best Christian podcasts in one place for your listening enjoyment. Cut through the noise and grow your faith by diving into the world's top Christian podcasts today. Download the Edify app for free from the App Store or Google Play, or by going to edify.app. That's edifi.app.
El Paseo Publications proudly supports the Westside Christian Fellowship Radio Network. We are committed to quality in Christian publication. Free ebooks can be found at westsidechristianfellowship.org under free ebooks. Books such as What Works for Men and What Works for Young Adults will help readers understand that the obstacles ahead are never greater than God's power to take you through. Books such as What Works When Diets Don't and Feasting and Fasting demonstrate how health can be achieved from a biblical perspective. Other free books such as Answers for a Confused Church and Desperate for More of God show the importance of fully surrendering our lives to Christ. And One Nation Above God is a must-read for anyone concerned about the direction of America. Again, free downloads of these ebooks are available at westsidechristianfellowship.org. We are happy about partnering with the Westside Christian Fellowship Radio Network.